Thou wilt direct my help, my Lord, and the deliverer of my death. I cry unto the Lord, let discriminative or personal thoughts should be, the team should be glad everyone should be praised as part of our hand. The mouth of them is God, speak their just name. At the dawn of man could come, meditate on these mountains, come out, or help them to learn to rejoice. My soul and peace have been our right hand and foot to follow. Glory to the Father, to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. O now and ever, and unto the ages of ages, amen. Alleluia, 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 glory to the Lord God. Alleluia, 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 glory to the Lord God. Alleluia, 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 glory to the Lord God. Lord have mercy, Lord have mercy, Lord have mercy. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
O now and ever, and unto the ages of ages, amen. O Lord God, my salvation, by day, by pride, by night, before thee, let my prayer before thee, God, down on your earth, and with thee. For fill this people to my soul, my life, and to the days I've gone out. And count the dead of the ground, and the dead, and recount the ground, I felt fear of the dead, like the bodies of the slain, the sick and the great. Now remember us the more, and they come from my hand. May they be in love, fit in the darkness and shadow of death. Against me is my anger made strong, and all my will is cast out of my mind. Thou shalt remove all my friends apart from me. They have made an abomination of themselves, and been delivered up and not put forth. My eyes are growing deep from poverty, I find that the Lord is moving on. I stretch out my hands unto thee, seeing the dead will not go under, or shall position waste and not be made, give thanks unto thee. They shall be in the grave called by mercy, and by healing and destruction. They shall never be known in the darkness of their righteousness, the land of God. But as for me unto thee, O Lord, my cry, and the morning shall I prepare for before thee. Wherefore, O Lord, as I put up my soul and turn my face away from thee. A poor man am I, and in trouble to my day, having been exalted, I was humbled and brought to the guest. Thy fury was fast upon me, and my parents were silent upon me. They came out about my water, where they loaned their comfort to God together. Thou shalt remove far from me, kind and neighbor, and my afflictions to prove my name's misery. O Lord God, my salvation, my day, my heart, my hand before thee. Let my prayer come before thee, God, thou thy fury, my supplication. Bless the Lord, my soul, and all that is perfectly blessed is holy name. Bless the Lord, my soul, and pray, and all that feel done for thee. Who is gracious unto all thy iniquities, who fills all thy infirmities, who redeems thy life from corruption, who crowns thee with mercy and compassion, who fills thy desires with good things, that you shall be renewed as the eagle, the one who holds deeds of mercy and executed judgment for all that are wrong. Yet faith raises on us the wilderness of the Son of Israel and is the unfilled. Compassionate and merciful is the Lord, long suffering, plenteous of mercy, not unto the ever to be angry, neither unto eternity will be withdrawn. Not according to our iniquities, have you dealt with us, neither according to our sins, have you rewarded us. For according to the height of heaven, from the earth, the Lord has made his mercy to prevail over them that fear him. As far as the east is from the west, so far will he remove our iniquities from us. As his Father hath compassion upon the Son, so the Lord hath compassion upon them that fear him. For he knoweth far from our days, death and heaven that fear us. As for man, whose days are as the grass, as the flower of the field, so shall he blossom forth. For when the end is passed over, then it shall be long, and the long will the work of his thereof. But the mercy of the Lord is from eternity even unto eternity upon him that fear him, and his righteousness is upon the Son of the Son of heaven, upon him that keeps testament and wherever his hand is to him. The Lord in heaven has prepared his throne and his kingdom to rule over the world. Bless the Lord, O Lord, his angels, mighty and strength, and perform his word, and give us his glory. Bless the Lord, O Lord, his word. Bless the Lord, all of his hosts and the nations that do his will. Bless the Lord with his works in every place he's given and bless the Lord of our soul. In every place he's given and bless the Lord of our soul. O Lord, who have turned the good for justification and that you depart and that you be my righteousness. And then the knowledge of judgment that has served me before thy sight shall know now that you be justified. For the enemy will persecute my soul, yet who will abide in my spirit, yet sat in the darkness. As those that have been long dead, and have prayed before me as you come to follow me. Forgive me my heart in trouble, I remember days of old I meditated on all thy words, I pondered on the creation of thy hands. I stretched forth my hands unto thee, my
salvation of our souls, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For the peace of the whole world, for the good estate of the holy churches of God, and for the union of all men, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For this holy house and for those who with faith, reverence, and the fear of God enter therein, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Our Father, Metropolitan Joseph, for the venerable priesthood, the active in Christ, for all the clergy and the people, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For Metropolitan Paul and Archbishop John, and for their quick release from captivity and safe return, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For the President of the United States, for all civil authorities and for armed forces everywhere, especially for Peter, Josh, Armani, Adam, Andrew, Benjamin, Thaddeus, Connor, Skyler, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
This city and for every city and land, and for the faithful who dwell therein, for healthful seasons, for abundance of the fruits of the earth, and for peaceful times, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For travelers by sea, by land, and by air, for the sick and the suffering, for captives and for their salvation, for those under persecution for the faith, for our deliverance from all tribulation, wrath, danger, necessity, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Help us, save us, have mercy upon us, and protect us, O God, by your grace.
Lord, have mercy.
Calling to remembrance our all holy immaculate, most blessed and glorious Lady Theotokos, and ever Virgin Mary, with all the saints, let us commend ourselves and each other and all our life unto Christ our God.
For unto thee are due all glory, honor, and worship, to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto ages of ages.
Amen.
each other and all our life unto Christ our God.
Thank you.
let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Holy art thou, our God, and unto thee we ascribe glory, to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto ages of ages.
Let us pray to the Lord God.
Mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy.
Wisdom, stand upright. Let us hear the Holy Gospel.
Peace be to all.
And to thy
spirit. Reading from the Holy Gospel according to St. Luke.
Glory to thee, O Lord,
glory to thee.
Let us be attentive.
At that time, Jesus took with him Peter and James and John and went up to the mountain to pray. And as he was praying, the appearance of his countenance was altered, and his raiment became dazzling white. And behold, two men talked with him, Moses and Elijah, who appeared in glory and spoke of his departure, which he was to accomplish at Jerusalem. Now Peter and those who were with him were heavy with sleep. And when they wakened, they saw this glory and the two men who stood with him. And as the men were parting from him, Peter said to Jesus, Master, it is well that we are here. Let us make three booths, one for you and one for Moses and one for Elijah, not knowing what he said. And as he said this, a cloud came and overshadowed them, and they were afraid as they entered the cloud. And a voice came out of the cloud saying, This is my beloved Son, listen to him. And when the voice had spoken, Jesus was found alone. And they kept silence and told no one in those days anything of what they had seen.
Glory to thee, O Lord, glory to thee.
Behold, I was conceived in iniquity, and conceived in sin, my mother bare me. Behold,
thy people and bless thy inheritance, visit thy world with mercy and compassion, exalt the poor and Orthodox Christians, and send down upon us thy rich mercies, through the intercessions of our all Immaculate Lady, Theotokos, and ever Virgin Mary, by the might of the precious and life-giving cross, by the protection of the honorable bodiless powers of heaven, at the supplication of the honorable glorious prophet, forerunner, and Baptist John, of the holy, glorious, all laudable apostles, Peter and Paul, and of all the holy apostles, of our fathers, Lamanna, Saints Patriarchs, and ecumenical teachers, Basil, the great Gregory, the theologian, and John Chrysostom, Athanasius, Cyril, and John, the merciful patriarchs of Alexandria, Nicholas, and Myers, Spirit of Trimegus, and Nectarius, and Pentapolis, the wonder workers of our fathers among the saints, Deacon, Patriarch of Moscow, and Raphael, Bishop of Brooklyn, of the holy, glorious, great martyr, George, the trophy bearer, Demetrius, the first beaver, Theodore, the soldier, Theodore, and the general, and Venus, the wonder worker of the higher martyrs, Ignatius, the God-bearer of Antioch, Maranopos, and Eleutherios, of the holy, glorious, great women, martyrs, Thecla, Barbara, Anastasia, Catherine, Kiriaki, Fotini, Marina, Paris, Cuba, and Irene, of the holy, glorious, bright, victorious martyrs, of our venerable and God-bearing fathers who shone in the ascetic life of Saint Barnabas, the patron and protector of this holy community, of the holy and righteous ancestors of God, Joachim and Anna, of the holy, glorious, and bright, victorious martyr, Eusebius of Antioch, and new martyr, Habakkuk of Thessalonica, whose memory we celebrate today, and of all thy saints, who beseech thee, O most merciful Lord, hearken unto the petitions of us sinners, who make our supplications unto thee, and have mercy upon us.
This is why we sing the Kata Vatsi of the Holy Cross, which we sing.
the Roman prophets, and that's why Moses and Elijah appear as his servants. Until then, our Lord manifested his divine power many times to the disciples, but on Mount Tabor, who manifested his divine nature, this vision of the divinity and the hearing of heavenly witness adopted as the Son of God and the Son of the disciples in the day of our Lord's passion and strengthening of an unwavering faith in him, his final victory. Unto Christ God, be glory to him. Thank you.
again. Please let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Help us, save us, have mercy on us, and keep us, O God, by thy grace.
Lord, have mercy.
Falling to remembrance our all holy, immaculate, most blessed and glorious ladies and holy and ever virgin Mary. With all the saints, let us commend ourselves and each other and all our life unto Christ our God.
To thee, O Lord.
Through the prayers of our holy fathers, Lord Jesus Christ our God, have mercy upon us and save us.
Oh. accept our prayer. You sit on the right hand of the Father, have mercy on us. For you alone are holy, you alone are the Lord Jesus Christ, to the glory of God the Father. Amen. Every morning I will bless you and praise you.
Master.
Blessed is the kingdom of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit, now and ever and unto ages of ages.
In peace, let us pray to the Lord. And for the salvation of our souls, let us pray to the Lord. For the peace of the whole world, for the good state of the holy churches of God, and for the union of all men, let us pray to the Lord. For this holy house and for those who with faith, reverence, and the fear of God intermarry, let us pray to the Lord. For our Father, Metropolitan Joseph, for the Venerable Priesthood, the Diaconate in Christ, for all the clergy and the people, let us pray to the Lord. For Metropolitan Paul and Archbishop John, and for their quick release from captivity and safe return, let us pray to the Lord. For the President of the United States, for all civil authorities, and for armed forces everywhere, especially for Peter, Joshua, Ronnie, Adam, Benjamin, Thaddeus, Scott, Connor, and Andrew, let us pray to the Lord. For this city and for every city and land, and for the faithful who dwell therein, for healthful seasons, for abundance of the fruits of the earth, and for peaceful times, let us pray to the Lord. For travelers by sea, by land, and by air, for the sick and the suffering, for captives and for their salvation, for those under persecution for the faith, for our deliverance from all tribulation, wrath, danger, and necessity, let us pray to the Lord. Help us, save us, have mercy upon us, and protect us, O God, by your grace.
Lord, have mercy.
Calling to remembrance our all-holy, immaculate, most blessed and glorious Lady Theotokos, and ever-Virgin Mary, with all the saints, let us commend ourselves and each other and all our life unto Christ our God.
Thank you.
each other and all our life unto Christ our God.
Thank you.
down, stand upright.
Oh, magnificent are your works. Bless the Lord, O my soul. Wisdom. The reading is from St. Peter's second universal letter.
Let us attend.
Brethren, be more zealous to confirm your call and election. For if you do this, you will never fall. So there will be riches provided for you, an entrance into the eternal kingdom of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Therefore, I am here always to remind you of these things, though you know them and are established in the truth that you have. I think it right, as long as I'm in this body, to arouse you by way of reminder, since I know that the putting off of my body will be soon, as our Lord Jesus Christ showed me. And I will see to it that after my departure, you may be able to, at any time, recall these things. For we did not follow cleverly devised myths when we were made known to you the power and coming of our Lord Jesus Christ, but we were eyewitnesses of his majesty. For when he received honor and glory from God the Father, and the voice was borne to him by the majestic glory, "This is my beloved Son, with whom I am well pleased," we heard this voice born from heaven, for we were with him on the holy mountain, and we have the prophetic word made more sure. You do well to pay attention to this, as to a lamp shining in a dark place, until the day dawns and the morning star rises in your hearts.
Peace be to thee that readeth.
Proclaim it,
the two trumpets of the Old and New Testament resound in full agreement, and everything needed to witness to it in ancient times is reunited with the teaching of the gospel. Of course, he's speaking about the Old Testament law and the prophets through Moses and Elijah, and the New Testament through Peter, James, and John, bearing witness together to Christ. The pages of both testaments, in fact, confirm each other. And he who was promised by the ancient symbols under the veil of mystery is now manifested by the blaze of his glory. It is he, as John would later say, the law was given by Moses, but grace and truth came to us through Jesus Christ, in whom has been fulfilled not only the promises by the prophetic figures, but also the meaning of the precepts of the law, because by his presence he teaches the truth of prophecy, and by his grace makes possible the practice of the commandments. Inspired by the revelation of the mysteries and taken up by contempt and disgust for earthly things, the Apostle Peter was in ecstasy at the desire of eternal things, and filled with the joy of this vision, wanted to live with Jesus, where his glory was manifested. That's why he said, "Lord, it is good for us to be here. If you want, we will build three tabernacles," tents, "one for you, one for Moses, and one for Elijah." But the Lord did not reply to this suggestion, certainly not to show that his desire was bad, but to signify that it was out of place. The world could not be saved without the death of Jesus, you see. Thus, the Lord's example calls on the faith of believers who understand that, no doubt against the promise of happiness, we must, nevertheless, in the trials of this life, ask for patience before glory. The happiness of the kingdom cannot, in fact, precede the time of suffering. So you get the picture. Peter seeing the glory of heaven through Christ and the prophets, wanted to build a tabernacle, wanted to live there and remain in that glory. But no, it can't happen. Not without first the cross, not without suffering, and a sense of alienation from God. Only then can we enter into his glory. And so while he was still speaking, a bright cloud overshadowed them, and a voice from the cloud said, "This is my beloved Son, in whom I am well pleased. Listen to him." The Father was present in the Son, and in that light that the Lord had measured out to the disciples, the essence of him who generates is not separated from the generated only begotten. But to highlight the proper characteristics of each person, the voice coming out of the cloud announced the Father to human ears, just as the splendor coming forth from the body revealed the Son to human eyes. When they heard the voice, the disciples fell face down, very frightened, trembling, not only before the majesty of the Father, but also before that of the Son. Through the motion of a deep understanding, in fact, they understood the divinity of both. And since there was no hesitation in faith, there was no discretion in fear, that divine testimony was so great and the power of words so clear, the disciples understood more than the voice could express. So when the Father says, "This is my beloved Son, whom I am well pleased, listen to him," they understood, of course, the divinity of God speaking, God the Father, and the divinity of the Son being testified to by the Father. And they understood also, according to St. Leo, "This is my Son, who does not take away from me my divinity, nor does he divine power, nor eternity. This is my Son, who is not adopted, not created, but generated from me, no different in nature than me. He is of my very being, and was born equal to me. This is my Son, through whom all things were made, and without whom nothing was made. All that I do, he also does. And as I work, he works with me without difference. In fact, the Father is in the Son, just as the Son is in the Father, and our unity never separates. And though I, the one who generates, is different from the one generated, it is not, however, allowed to have a different opinion about him, that one can have of me. This is my son, who did not count equality of me with me something to be grasped at or to usurp, appropriating it for himself. Rather, while remaining in the condition of his glory, he, to complete the design of the restoration of mankind, brought in humility, the immutable divinity, to the condition of a servant. To him, therefore, is due all my pleasures, and whose teachings I manifest, whose humility glorifies me. Listen to him without hesitation, for he is truth and life. He is my strength and my wisdom. One moment, please. Listen to him. This is my son, listen to him. He whom the mysteries of the law announce, from the voice of the prophet sang about. Listen to him, he who has redeemed the world with his blood, who has chained the devil and who snatched away the spoil, who has torn out the document of our debts and the covenant that oppressed us. Listen to him, he who opens the way to heaven, and with the agony of the cross prepares there the stairs leading up to the kingdom. Why are you afraid of being redeemed? Why are you afraid of being dissolved from your chains? Let it happen that what I wish Christ also wills. Throw away that carnal fear and arm yourself with the constancy that inspires faith. These things, beloved, were said not only for the good of those who heard it then with their ears. Rather, in the person of the three apostles, it is the whole church which learns that what they saw with their eyes and perceived with their ears. May it strengthen the faith of all according to the preaching of the Holy Gospel. And let no one be ashamed of the cross of Christ, through which the world has been redeemed. Consequently, let no one be afraid of suffering for righteousness, nor hesitate to receive the promised reward, because it is through labor that we gain rest, and life through death. In fact, he took upon himself the weakness of our own lowliness. And if we stay with him in his confession and in his love, we are winners of what he has won and will receive what he has promised. Whether it is that to perform the commandments or whether to endure the hardships of life, the voice of the Father which has sounded forth, "This is my beloved Son in whom I am well pleased. Listen to him," must always resound in our ears. For he lives and he reigns with the Father and the Holy Spirit forever and ever. Amen. Glory to God, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Holy Spirit, now and ever and unto age. Of the Lord.
Grant his soul.
Living,
complete the remaining time of our life in peace and repentance for a Christian ending to our life, painless, blameless, peaceful, and a good defense before the fearful judgment seat of Christ. Let us ask of the Lord.
And his soul.
All into remembrance are all holy, immaculate, most blessed and glorious Lady Theotokos, and ever Virgin Mary, with all the saints. Let us commend ourselves and each other and all our life unto Christ our God. That with one accord we may
Spirit.
praise thee, who give thanks unto thee, and who worship thee in every place of thy dominion. For thou art God, ineffable, inconceivable, invisible, incomprehensible, ever existing, and eternally the same. Thou and thine only begotten Son, thy Holy Spirit. Thou it was who didst bring us from non existence into being. And when we had fallen away, didst raise us up again. And didst not cease to do all things until thou hast brought us back to heaven, and hast endowed us with thy kingdom which is to come. For all these things we give thanks unto thee and to thy only begotten Son and thy Holy Spirit. For all things of which we know and of which we know not, and for all the benefits bestowed upon us, both manifest and unseen. And we give thanks unto thee also for this ministry, which thou didst vouchsafe to receive in our hands, even though there stand beside thee thousands of our great angels and thousands of angels, the cherubim and the seraphim, six-winged many are soaring aloft, borne on their pinions, singing the triumphal hymn, shouting, proclaiming, and saying,
Immaculate,
most blessed and glorious Lady of Hope, Ever Virgin Mary.
Thank you.
bow our heads unto the Lord.
Thank you. members of the Orthodox Church. And we have three new members that will be in line first for communion this morning.
With the fear of God, with faith and love, draw near.
Body and blood of our Lord Jesus.
mercy of God, love is the gift of
Thank you. Lord, have mercy.
produce new fruit in the vine, which thou hast graciously been pleased to permit to come to maturity. Through calm seasons, and gentle rains, and favorable weather. And let it be unto joy for those of us who shall partake of this offspring of the vine, and may we offer it as a gift unto thee, unto the purification of our sins, through the sacred and holy body and blood of thy Christ, with whom thou art blessed together with that all-holy good and life-giving spirit, now and ever, and unto ages of ages. Unto thee today on the occasion of their wedding anniversary, for all thy blessings bestowed upon them during the years of their marriage. Bless them always, O Lord, fill their life with good things, and accept their crowns into thy kingdom, keeping them pure, blameless, and above reproach forever. Amen. Let us pray to the Lord. Master, may this, our thanksgiving, be acceptable before the majesty of thy glory, as a sweet aroma of incense, and as a holy offering. Grant us thy rich mercy and bounties every day. Deliver thy holy church and this city from all the assaults of every visible and invisible enemy. Grant thy servants, Andrew, Stephanie, may live in health and without sin. Grant them advancement in every good thing, we pray thee. O most merciful King, hear us and have mercy. O Lord our God, who has espoused the church as a pure virgin from among the Gentiles, continue to bless this marriage and preserve your servants, Andrew, Stephanie, in a place of oneness of mind as thou hast thus far since their marriage 10 years ago. And grant them the fulfillment of their desires. Pour out upon them thine abundant blessings and mercy, for thou art a loving and merciful God. Grant them health, a long life, and success in all their good deeds, for thou art a good God who lovest mankind, and unto thee we ascribe glory. To the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto ages of ages. Life-giving Trinity, one in essence, one God in one kingdom. Bless you, Andrew. Bless you, Stephanie. And grant you a long life, prosperity, and faith. And may he bless you with an abundance of all good things on earth, and make you worthy to obtain the promised blessings through the prayers of the most holy Theotokos and of all the saints. And by the sprinkling of this holy water, may the blessing of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit descend upon you and remain with you forever. Amen. On the occasion of their 10th wedding anniversary, grant, O Lord, to thy faithful servants, Andrew and Stephanie, peace, health, salvation, a long life, and many years.
God grant you many years.
kingdom upon you through his grace and love towards mankind, always, now, and ever, and up to ages of ages. Glory to thee, O Christ, our God, and our whole glory to thee.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
Transfigured in glory before his holy disciples and apostles on Mount Tabor for our salvation, Christ our true God. Through the intercessions of his all immaculate and all blameless Holy Mother, by the might of the precious and life-giving cross, by the protection of the honorable bodiless powers of heaven, at the supplication of the honorable glorious prophet, forerunner, and Baptist John, of the holy, glorious, and all laudable apostles, of our Father among the saints, John Chrysostom, Archbishop of Constantinople, whose divine liturgy we have now celebrated, of the holy, glorious, and white victorious martyrs, of our venerable and God-fearing fathers, of Saint Barnabas, patron and protector of this holy community, of the holy and righteous ancestors of God, Joachim and Anna, and of all the saints, have mercy upon us and save us, for as much as he is poor and loves mankind. Through the prayers of our holy fathers, Lord Jesus Christ, our God, have mercy on us and save us.
Amen.